Yes, class.
So, see, we have to start with series and parallel combination. So, let us complete this. This last topic is left. So, here, charge remains constant when we are talking about the series combination. Okay, it means the potential will be changing. Like, look, what did we study? That if a device is connected, when the devices are present, then what did we notice? That charge remains same, but due to the presence of the device, due to that device, the charges will be remaining the same, but potential will be dividing. Right? That's what we have studied whenever we are talking about this. So if the charge is remaining the same and the potential is changing, let us do one thing. Let us take the net potential. What is the total potential? So V net is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4 up till V nth. So we have studied Q is equal to CV. So what is potential equal to? Charge divided by capacitance. So let us put the value. So total charge is the same because it's a series connection by total potential. Total capacitance, which is C equivalent, is equal to for V1, we will write Q is the same C1 by plus Q is the same by C2. Up till how many, let's say nth number of charges are present, still the charge will be Q divided by CNN. Now see, all the value of charges will be cancelled. 1 by C equivalent will be 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 plus 1 by C4 up till 1 by CNF. It depends number of capacitors which are present. So this is the total capacitance. Okay, now see, when we are talking about the charge, charge will be total capacitance into voltage, right? Now, but individual voltages, if you are calculating, this is the total voltage of the circuit. So individual voltages will be Q by C1, Q by C2, Q by CNF, like. Now, energy, what will be the energy? Half C equivalent square, V square is the total, or Q square by 2C equivalent is the total. But individual energies will be half C1 square, half C2 V2 square, like this. Or when you are talking in terms of Q and C, then it is Q square by 2C1, Q square by 2C2, like this. Okay. Even if you are calculating other things, like this is the capacitance. Capacitance you already know. C1 is equal to C. When you are calculating the capacitance, so it will simply be charge divided by the potential, but potential will be different. Okay, potential is going to be different. So our C1 will be equal to Q V1. Likewise, C2 will be Q by V2. Even if you're calculating some other things, like you're calculating power. So power, how do you calculate? Yes, what was the formula of power? We have discussed power. Oh, okay, we have not discussed power. Fine, let's leave this power. It is actually related to your charge. So basically it's related to current. So we'll see power later. We have not done power. Okay. So total charge, total potential, and total capacitance, all these things you should be knowing. So this you can we let us see the question later or start writing down from here. Okay, Taha has answered almost all the parts. Okay, he has answered all the parts. Very good, Taha. Let us discuss now. C equivalent, it's very easy to calculate C equivalent. Right? What will be C equivalent? First, we'll do the reciprocal. 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So, C equivalent is simply 5 into 10 by 5 plus 10. So, this is equal to 50 divided by 15. 10 by 3. So, Taha's answer 3.33. Correct. 3.33. Microfarad, nahi, farad is given here, na? Taha, how microfarad? 5 farad and 10 farad is given. 5 farad is given and 10 farad is given. This will be also in farad only. 3.33 farad. Correct. Okay, not micro. Second says total voltage across the circuit. Very good, Taha. Second answer is also correct. 10 volt. Total voltage is simply given, which is 10 volt. Third part, total charge stored. Okay, now you know the total. For total charge, you should know the total capacitance into the total potential. Total capacitance is 10 by 3, potential is 10. That is 100 by 3. So again, 33.3 correct. Taha, this is also right. What is fourth part? Charge stored in each. See, charge stored in each Q1 is equal to Q2, which is equal to our Q1. This is equal to 100 by 3. So, what was your answer, Taha? 33 points. Correct. Last part. Voltage across each. Yeah. So, in this voltage across each, V1 is equal to charge divided by C1. So charge is 100 by 3 divided by C1 is 1 is 5. So this becomes 20. 20 by 3 volt for the first one. And V2 will be equal to Q by C2, which is equal to 100 by 3 into 10. This is equal to 10 by 3. You can confirm whether your answer is right or not. See, if you add it, 20 by 3 plus 10 by 3 is equal to 30 by 3, which is equal to 10. And that was the total. Okay, write it quickly. Let's see the parallel combination then. So, 6.6, 3.3, correct. Good, Taha. Let's see the parallel combination now, class. I hope you have completed. See, in parallel combination, there is branching. So charge will divide, but potential will remain same. Okay, so what will be the total charge? The net charge will be equal to Q1 plus Q2 up till Qnth. So Q is equal to Cv. So C equivalent V, C1 into V, C2 into V. V will be the same because it's parallel combination. Up till Cnth into V. All the values of potential will be cancelling. So net capacitance is simply added. C1 plus C2 till Cnth. Okay, just simply add it. So this is a question. I write it and it's very easy question. We'll discuss it. See, what is your the answer? Taha, this time you didn't answer Sufyan, you should have answered. See, C current will be C1 plus C2. This is equal to 15. Why? Because 10 plus 5. Okay, Taha has solved again. Sufyan, your answer. Total voltage, correct. It will be 10 volt. Third part, total charge. So again, total charges, total capacitance into voltage 10 into 15, which is equal to 150 coulomb. So yes, that is also correct. Voltage across each. So V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V, which is equal to 10 volt. Correct. Fourth is also right. Fifth, you have submitted. So fifth is charge in each. See. Charge is first capacitance into potential. So capacitance is how much? 5. And this is 10. So this is equal to 50 coulomb. And second charge is equal to C2 into V. This is 10 into 110, which is equal to 100 coulomb. You can confirm also, see, when you add these two. So 100 plus 50 is equal to 150 coulomb. And this was the fifth part. So sixth part. And what was your answer, Taha? 50 and 100. Very good, Taha. These two you didn't do. Energy in each. See, energy in each when you are calculating. So energy in each will be half C1 V square. This is equal to half 5 into 10 into 10. Okay. So 500 by 2, 250 joules. And this is U2 is equal to half C2 V whole square. So this is equal to 2 into 10 into 10 into 10. So this is equal to 500 joules, not 1000. Seventh, total energy. See, you can directly add these U1 plus U2. So this is equal to 250 plus 500. So this is equal to 750 joules. Okay, write it. Yes, Taha, correct. All the answers are correct. Okay, so Sufyan has answered. Okay, let us check. See, firstly, what we'll do, we'll see these two. These are in parallel combination. Yes? So, in parallel combination, C, not C equivalent exactly. This is not the equivalent. Equivalent just for these two. So, C dash will be equal to 5 plus 10, which is equal to 15, right? 15 microfarad. Now, this 15 and this 10, these are further connected in series. So now we'll have 1 by C equivalent equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 15 microfarad. So C equivalent will be 10 into 15 by 10 plus 15. So this is equal to 150 divided by 25. So 530, this is equal to 6 microfarad. So, what was your answer? 40 by 3. It will be 40 by 3. 15 into 10, 150. 15 plus 10, 25. 5 into 5. And this is 30. So, it's 6. 6 microfarad. Write it, please. Yes, see, see how we'll solve this question. First, we'll start from this. So these are connected in parallel. So C12 will be equal to C plus C, which is equal to 2C. So this is 2C now. Now we have to solve this further. So these two are now connected in series. Yes. So C12 and C3, they are connected in series. So 1 by C123. Or directly, let me write it. C123 is equal to C12 into C3 by C12 plus C3. So this is equal to 2C into C by 2C plus C. So this is equal to 2C square divided by 3C. 1C, 1C will be cancelled. So 2C by 3. Now we can replace this with 2C by 3. Now we are left with this. So these two are again in series, and this is also C, C, C. So C 1, 2, 3, 4 will be 2C by 3 plus C. So this is 5C by 3. Now 5C by 3, C, these three are connected in series. So total equivalent capacitance is 1 by C plus 1 by C plus 3 by 5C. So LCM will be 5C. So this is 5 plus 5 plus 3. This is equal to 10, 13 by 5C. So equivalent capacitance here is, this is equal to 5C by 13. Write it.